بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. My project is about e-mentoring in medical education by Dr. Rania Azmi, Femur Fellow 2022 batch, Assistant Professor of Medical Biochemistry and Molecular Biology, Monofaya University, Deputy Manager of Quality Assurance Center of the University, and Vice Dean for Education and Student Affairs, Faculty of Dentistry, Monofaya University. The project is advised by Dr. Naveen Baha. As mentoring system is very crucial to the stability and success in higher education institution, and recognizing that the future is for the best use of the virtual world, my project came e-mentoring in medical education to evaluate the impact of using e-mentoring in improving overall performance of the mentoring system in my institution. My Gantt chart shows that the launch and the proposal preparation was at January 2022. IRP approval was obtained at February 2022. This was followed by team formation and assigning the roles of every member. The project plan was presented and totally clarified in the first meeting of the team. Establishment steps started included establishment of the academic supervision committee, putting vision, mission, and the goals for this committee, and taking approval from the education and the student affairs committee. To evaluate the current situation, the first survey was conducted at March 2022, and analysis of the survey was made on April. The survey tested the satisfaction of both the faculty members and the students on the already current system for mentoring. The design training plan to be executed at June and July for both the student and the faculty member. Implementation of the new system is to be at August, September, and October. At November 2022, the second survey should be conducted, and the results and satisfaction results will be compared to the results of the first survey. Poster preparation will start at December 2022 to be ready for presentation at 2023. The changes made to the project were at two steps: the implementation, establishment steps, the establishment of supervision, academic supervision committee at the level of the university was done at the same level at the Faculty of Medicine. The training workshops extended to August due to a change of the university learning management system from LAKB to Thanki. So the faculty members and the students needed to have more training on the learning management system. The lessons learned is good planning is needed for any change to succeed. Changing concepts is the key to change behavior. Good relations between students and staff member is very essential for keeping the academic life stable. Thank you.